Hello there, Fellowship of the Rye, Harvey here. I'm smoking with my pipe buddy Kevin here in, I think Nescafe, right?
Nestle Cafe.
First time that we are both here in the smoking room of this place. And I'm smoking, thanks to Kevin, The wine.
Or Jim will correct you on that one.
Really good. Very, very mellow, if you ask me. In my Nero, the only one that I have. Really good. And Kevin will do the same later on. We're gonna try something different today. We are usually, when we have conversations, it's because you are agreeing with something, and we found out that we have a very different idea with respect of what Kevin talked about in, I think it's your latest video? Okay. And I sent him a PM where I talked briefly about it, of how different we thought about that, and it's the matter of if I wouldn't say that if it's okay, but if there is a good reason to mix blends or not. And Kevin's point was very clear in favor of not, of having the tobacco as it is, and not mix it up, or not try to modify it in any way. Now, granted, you should consider that I'm the last person you should ask about how a tobacco tastes. So, putting that aside, I think the amount of blends that there are available out there, it's so huge that it's true you could find something that will please you in every single matter for a particular mood that you might be. You want something sweet, you might want something spicy, you want something strong, in terms of room note, strength, and so on. You can find it. You can potentially find it. It's a matter of choice, right? But my argument is, if there is a blend that you enjoy, but something is missing in that blend, let's say, a good example for that is Billy Q. You have Billy Bob and 1Q. 1Q that goes as a very good aromatic, a top quality aromatic for me, that I enjoy a lot. Extremely mellow, extremely sweet. The word extremely sometimes is not good. Billy Bud, on the other hand, the cigar leaf, a very strong English, proper English kind of tobacco from Canada. That it goes again, like on the side of extremely strong. You could argue very easily that you enjoy those two blends apart, of course, when you want something sweet and when you want something strong. But it's not a bad idea to mix them up. You know that you like both, and you can experiment, and you have that freedom of experiment and say, you know what, that's exactly what I was looking for. A toned down Billy Bud, if you're mixing most of it Billy Bud, and then you mix it up with a little bit of Billy Q. Or on the other side, a stronger 1Q when you put a little bit of Billy Bud. Furthermore, my idea of layering tobacco in which you put half of something and then another half of something, or even three tobaccos, it's something that I enjoy. I know that the tobacco you're smoking, it will change complexity. But I think it's also another feature that you may strive for. So, let's hear from Kevin what he thinks about this. And how about if you go with the housekeeping?
Okay, smoking my newest pipe here. This is a Yocono, it's a horn, and the grade is a bishop, so I call it the horny bishop. And I'm smoking some Penzance in it. This is gonna be a bit hard. I'm even gonna try and talk with this one, because I just spit tobacco out of it in this particular shape. Okay, so yeah, I do feel a bit differently about tobacco. So my feeling is that the person who blended this tobacco or this tobacco, these are the people who know their craft. They're you, you can even call them artists or artisans. That's their job, and you know, this is the statement. This is what they want to say. So I feel that as a pipe smoker, my job is to, I have a job, but my job is to appreciate what they have to say. Listen to what they have to say. If I don't like it, fine, I won't smoke it again. I'll find something different. If I kind of like it, I'll find something similar to it. But I just don't believe in altering what they want to say. I don't want to paraphrase it. I just want to accept it on their terms. This is their statement, and it's mine to like, to reject, or to find something to replace it with. And that's how I feel about it.
All right, good. You have a question or questions for me? I have a couple for you.
Do you not feel that you are potentially violating the artistic statement of the blend?
Yeah, okay. So that's a good point, the word artistic, because I would say that I think you briefly mentioned that on your video, like, why would you modify a pipe? Like, it's the statement from the pipe maker, the artisan, the master who made the pipe. Why would you do it? I'll tell you why, because I like a wider draft hole, for instance. I prefer that. It will be harder if it's wider. I want to narrow it down, but that's a good example of something that you could do. If you would like the same a little bit more bend, you can easily do that as well, because you prefer that. That's a matter of a preference. So I respect that, the statement that the blender does, and I acknowledge their expertise, but the bottom line is, I'm the one who's smoking it. And it's not only if I have the right or not to do it, because of course we'll both agree that I have the right to do it. Because anyways, my tobacco, and I put it in pipe, whatever I want. But I think it's more a matter of finding that thing that you will enjoy even more. And if you have those features in one tobacco that you're thinking, you know what? This thing that I will miss is this little bit of spiciness. I would like a little bit of a spiciness there. You know, you have to put perique or a blend that has a little bit of perique, and you will have that, and you will have that enjoyment. So I don't think I might be over the line in terms of the blender. I understand that concept, but at the end, I think it's all about how I enjoy what I'm smoking. Not accepting or not accepting that. It's more about that. And I have a question for you. So, you're telling us that it should be your job to accept or not accept the blend that you have in your pipe.
Every blend stands on its own terms.
And as an art, I would compare this with what a chef will do with a meal. A proper chef, I mean, we're not talking about any chef, but a professional chef.
Yeah.
My question for you is, would you put salt on that?
I never put salt on the table. When I'm cooking, I'll put salt in the recipe, but I never use salt on the table.
Yeah, but...
Never have.
But if... Or for that matter, pepper or something else that when you taste it, you say, like, you know what? Black pepper will be nice. Spice will be nice. Okay. A little bit more spicy here.
I will, for example, put hot sauce on pizza or something like that.
Yeah, but pizza is a... I love pizza. But let's say a chef, or perhaps a pizza that is like, whoa, my goodness, I mean, that's like an art kind of pizza. Would you still put the hot sauce? Because that's their statement.
Right. No, I don't think I would. If I wanted something spicy, yeah, I would try to order a pizza that had, you know, peppers or something on it. But no, I don't think I would in that case.
Okay, cool. All right. In my case, to close up my argument, I think is I kind of understand the, I don't know, the duty that the pipe smoker may have in terms of having the pipe and the smoking and not just having it in a shelf, right? Not as a collector. And the same could go easily extrapolated to the blends, and I understand that idea. But I think that since there are so many blends out there and so limited amount of money and time to try them all, the fact that I can have some of them and mix them up and say, you know what, this actually works or doesn't work, it is not only my choice, but a chance that I have to enjoy even more what I'm having in the pipe. Mind you again, I'm really poor at tasting tobacco, but what I get that I enjoy, the thing that is so smooth and has a little bit of a strength in the flavor side, flavor, if I can call that, is something for me that it's really important, I guess. How about you?
I fully accept that, you know, I'm not saying that my way is the right way and everybody has to try it. I'm simply saying that my way is what works for me. I will also concede about the pipe issue, that yes, definitely if a pipe is too, has a constricted draw, I would be all in favor of opening it up. I wouldn't do it myself because I don't trust myself. I probably wouldn't send it out just because it takes so long to do it and get it back and all that. But I would not, you know, but talking about altering the engineering is different than altering the wood or the shape of the pipe on the outside. With tobacco, again, I just feel that, as I said in my last video, smoking a pipe is a dialogue between me, the pipe carver, and the blender. And it's a matter of choosing the right pipe for the right moment, the right pipe for the right tobacco for the right moment, and it's all engaging in a dialogue, and that is what pipe smoking is all about to me.
Okay, cool. All right. There you heard. That's a very small debate, and it's pretty close of what we do without the joking and the laughter when we have a pipe with Kevin. So there you go. Leave your comments. What do you think about it? Do you mix your tobacco? You don't? You try more and more blends? I bet if you have deep pockets, you may go for that. But I don't know. If you have any comments, I'm pretty sure that either Kevin or I will be more than happy to hear your opinion. With that, I think this is the longest video ever that I had. My apologies, I'm not for that, but I think...
Well, it's two of us.
Well, it's two of us, so divide this in half. With that, my friends, as always, puff away.